Hello everyone, my name is Sayeka. Today we are going to see a Laplace transformation of f of t equals to t, and we are going to do some math related to the transformation, and we are going to learn about Laplace transformation a bit. And now just let's shift to the whiteboard where we can do the math. So here's the whiteboard. Okay. We are all set now for doing the math. So let me grab my marker. Yeah. So Laplace transformation function is defined as this is Laplace operator of f of t equals to integration of 0 to infinity f of t into e power minus st dt. This is the Laplace transformation function, and we are going to use this function to find the Laplace transformation of f of t equals to t. Now, substituting f of t equals to t in the above equation, we get Laplace transformation of t equals to 0 to infinity t into e power minus st dt. So, now we are going to solve this equation. This is a in this integral, for solving this integral, we have two functions, t and e power minus st. Using the formula of Euler, this is a just small mnemonic used for determining which is the primary function and secondary function. Inverse logarithmic, algebraic, trigonometric, exponential. So, this is going to be the primary function or first, and this is going to be secondary function or second. Okay, now for solving this, we need to use the UV rule. So this is UV rule. UV dt equals to U, this is primary and this is secondary, V dt minus integration of du by dt into integral of V dt whole dt. So we are going to use this theorem or this result here. So by applying it directly, 0 to infinity, and here you get t outside the factor, and e power minus st dt minus integral 0 to infinity, where du by dt is going to be 1, because differentiation of t is 1, into integral of e power minus st dt, okay, and whole integral dt, okay. Now we are not going to worry about limits. Limits are going to be taken care at the end. So by solving this one, so an important thing here is that e power minus st integral is nothing but minus 1 by s into e power minus st. That's a pretty easy one. Now substituting here, we get 0 to infinity minus 1 by s into e power minus st dt. Okay, now again doing this one, taking the 1 by s outside, and again solving it, we finally get the result minus st plus 1 by s square. Sorry, it's minus actually, sorry. My 1 by s square e power minus st, that's it. And the limits are from 0 to infinity, and here also 0 to infinity. Okay, so let me just rub this part. Now, so this is the value. Okay, so this thing is divided into two parts, the infinity value, the value of the limit at infinity, and the value of the limit at zero. So we are going to solve the initial values first. Just by plugging in the infinity in this case, where t equals to infinity, you see that you get the e power minus infinity term. So e power minus infinity is nothing but zero, so we can rule out the whole infinity term as zero. And while plugging 0 here, we have the t term. So if t is equal to 0, the whole expression nullifies. So here we get 0. So the whole term of minus t by s e power minus st is 0. That's a good thing because our equation has been simplified. Now coming to here, just like the previous case, we are going to apply e power minus st infinity. So e power minus infinity, it's going to be 0. So the whole term is going to be 0 at infinity. While substituting 0, we get e power minus 0, that equals to 1. So we get minus 1 by s square. This is a thing. Now our whole thing is our Laplace function, which has been which gave us a relation here, the equation here, has been simplified to this form. So let me just write it down. So by writing it down, we get 0 minus 0, that's the first term, plus 0 minus 1 by minus s square, that equals to 1 by s square. So Laplace function of t is 1 by s square. Today we have derived 1 by s square, which is the Laplace transformation of t. The Laplace transformation has very uses in engineering and in science. These are very helpful in solving ODEs. And not to forget, there are some specific conditions where we can apply Laplace transformation. The conditions, simply we can state it down as t is greater than 0 or equals to, and s is also greater than 0. That's the simple conditions. That's the end of our video. Done.